MacBook is a 30-point Linux machine on Hack2Box. We log into a web application as administrator by exploiting a SQL truncation and then use a local file inclusion vulnerability to obtain an SSH key. By exploiting a logrotate CVE, we escalate privileges to root. The initial port scan shows Apache on port 80 and SSH. When we visit the website, we can see that it is allowed to register a user, so we do just that and then log into the application. We then start by exploring the application a bit. On books, there's a list of books with a picture, a book title, and an author. When clicking on the picture, we can download the book as we can see in the link. Search allows us to search for an author by his name, and on the feedback form, we can send the administrator a message. On collections, we can upload a file and provide a book title and author. Finally, there's another contact form that allows us to send another message, this time showing us the administrator's email address. There's also some user options menu where we can change our username. After exploring the app a bit, we download the book PDF and then upload it again via the collections form. On search, the new book can now be found by the author's name. While this shows that everything is working as intended, it doesn't help us much yet. When we try to change our username to something long, we notice that it gets truncated to 10 characters, which is a bit unusual. Now, I will cheat a bit and show you what is actually going on to understand the next step. When you register a new user, the application looks in the database if the email you entered already exists. If this is not the case, you can register the account. On logging into the application, it then checks whether a user with that email and password combination exists, and if it does, you can get in. Let us look at the database. The email field is of length 20, which means that any additional characters will be cut off. This cutoff is not a default setting in MySQL and requires specific configuration changes and is also dependent on the database version. Now, the idea is to register a user that has an email address that will pass the first check but truncates to admin@book.htb. This would mean that we can later log in with our username and password combination because we added another row with the admin email address and it just checks if at least one valid combination exists in the database. We register a new user and change the email address to admin@book.htb, followed by a lot of spaces and some additional characters. On insert, everything longer than 20 characters will be truncated. The spaces will still be there, but are ignored on comparisons for type varchar, which means that we can now log in as admin. Now, we really don't have any additional options here as administrator, so we fuzz the web root a bit, looking for some kind of admin area. Eventually, we find an admin subdirectory and find another login form where we can log in with the same credentials. Here we can see the users and submitted messages. On collections, it's possible to download a summary of users and books. This is interesting because this exported PDF will contain user-supplied input data such as the author and book title. We look at payloads that could help us here and find a blog post that shows how we can insert a JavaScript payload to include the local file. We copy the payload and include etc passwd. After downloading the collection, we can see that it worked and the file got included. This is possible because the box uses the Node.js tool HTML PDF in a vulnerable version. In the passwd file, the user reader sticks out and we send another payload targeting his private key, which succeeds. Now this key is a bit messed up and in my default PDF viewer I couldn't really copy it out. But opening it in Chrome and then copying out all contents helped. We SSH into the box as a reader and can read the user flag. To look for ways to escalate privileges, we run lse.sh, which is already placed onto the box. There isn't really anything interesting in the output though. To get some additional information, we run psspy. This shows that root is running logrotate and also seems to SSH into the box at regular intervals. We grab for the logrotate version and look for exploits. One of the first hits shows the logrotten exploit, which is exactly what we will use here. We copy the code into a file onto the box and compile it. The README shows that we will need a payload file that is run when we succeed and also a target log file. In Reader's home folder in backups, we can find the log file we require. As a payload, we just set the setuid bit on bash. Finally, we can run the exploit and then have to write some garbage into the access log to trigger the rotation. Now we must wait until root SSHs into the box again, because the exploit wrote our payload to etc bash completion d. After a moment, this succeeds. We run bash to become root and can read the flag.